in 2012.
Ladies and gentlemen, my right, Ina Kjærsfeldt, Denmark. On my left, Chloe Magni, Ireland. Chloe Magni to serve, love or play.
You're very welcome back to our live coverage here on Air TV and Badminton World TV around the world. Third final of the day, women's singles. Chloe Magni, Ireland's number one, against sixth seed, the up-and-coming Danish talent of Line Kjærsfeldt. Crowd here for sure going to be firmly behind Magni, but Lina will be totally unfazed by that. Very focused young woman. Struggled with some form early this season. This Irish Open marking a comeback to form for Lina. Final victory over a very highly fancied Olga Konin of Germany. Two close games certainly indicates that the Dane is on form and has the ability to take this. And has a super net shot from Lina. Early round victory for Lina over Soraya de Vischijbergen of the Netherlands. Another one of these up and coming young women's singles players from Europe. Winning in 2, 22, 20, 21, 19. Another indication of Lina's return to form. Chloe, of course, taking the three in the semi-final against Spain's Beatriz Corrales. To winning the first, she had two match points in the second game, but the gutsy Spaniard fought it out, pulled it back, and took that second game. But Magni remained composed and focused and ran out 21-12 winner in the decider. Again, struggled in the first game against Sarah Milne of England. in the quarterfinal. 24-22, and then taking the second 21-14. So both girls in reasonably good form. Spoken about Lena Karsfeld as the likely successor to the great Tina Bowen. Tina, of course, hanging up her racket at the All England in 2013, a tournament which she made her own. Won it twice, of course. Lena, big shoes to fill.
So the summer, six.
Interesting to note, Lena, one of those players who excels at not only singles but doubles and mixed. But this week in Ireland, just playing singles, and by no coincidence that she'd made the final. Focusing just on the one discipline this week, I think has made a huge difference to Lena Karsfeld. Maybe that's the catalyst. Danish youngster to make her mind up one way or the other. An angle on the cross court drop from Karsfeld. And from 5-5, a run of 5 points in the serve of Lena Karsfeld takes her within one of the interval lead. Two met recently, of course, at the Dutch Open. Chloe victorious on that occasion, 16 and 12. But I think this is a different Lena Karsfeld. And a good interval lead, 11-6. Superb play, Karsfeld. Of course, Lena, the reigning European Junior Champion, not in singles, mixed doubles with her partner Kim Astrup Sorensen.
7-12. The server, 37.
This is certainly a good start for the Dane. Lena rolls her eyes to heaven. Error on the drop shot. Carsfeld followed up with a smash down the backhand side of McGee for the winner. Oh, superb net control again from the Dane.
59.
Oh, it's better from Chloe. Yes, the crowd liked that one. Good disguise.
10-15.
Showing the push down the line. Deception to play the net shot. Oh.
So the server, 16-10.
Then undoing all the good work with a bad serve. Shows much emotion punching the air on that occasion, just taking the power out of the smash, going for accuracy. Again,
18-10.
Just out.
So it's over. 13-19.
Just out from Lena. Good return of serve.
14-19.
Chloe, wide awake. Quick feet from McGee. Locking it on the backhand. Thank you.
Troy McGee.
Good spell this for the Irish number one. Of course, two-time Olympian. Some concentration, I feel, from the Dane. Silly mistake on the return of serve. She was trailing 19-12. That's better. A little bit more patient from Lena. Takes the Dane to game point. Good length from Chloe.
19-20.
Back to within one now of Lena Karsfeld. All of a sudden, the Chloe McGee levels it up. 20-20. Backhand pull cross court. McGee fully aware of the poor backhand from Lena. And it's Chloe who goes to game point. Can she pull this one out of the fire? Good play from Lena Karsfeld.
21-0.
Shot from Karsfeld at the net. Superb. What a time to play the shot. Such a crucial juncture in the first game. And then the smash out wide for the winner. Two in a row for the Dane. Takes Lena to game point. The flick serve. Proving fruitful for Karsfeld. Somehow Lena managed to get over the line. Remember, she was leading 18-9 at one point. And Chloe, slowly but surely, fought her way back in. Lapse in concentration, I feel, a little bit from Lena. But Chloe will certainly feel she almost has the momentum. Lost the first game, but will feel a certain amount of momentum on her side. And Lena just needs to remain focused. Not lose concentration. So second game, Lena for sure will feel relieved after finally clinching that first game after having such a commanding lead. But certainly McGee. That's a little bit of a wave of momentum on her side. Oh, a little bit of luck for Chloe. Kjaer felt fully concentrated, able to play the winner to the open court. Good smash on the flick serve. Good aggressive return of serve from Lena, unable to finish off the point. Was there to be killed. Good start for Chloe, leading 5-2. Always a good point of attack to put the shuttle back to the point where your opponent is coming from. Big round of applause. Good play from Chloe. Good control at the net. Superb pulling the shuttle cross court and then good footwork. Round ahead, cross court from Kjaersfeld, a long way out. Well played from the Dane. Exposing Chloe on the backhand side with the smash. Good to interception on the push down the line. Oh, superb rally. What a rally. Appreciative round of applause for Lena Karsfeld. Great fighting from the Dane. Just in, Chloe. Feeling the shuttle was out. Yeah, hitting the line. Chloe looking at the umpire in hope more than anything, I think. Close. Lena may have been borderline across the net, but I don't think Chloe can have any complaints. It was Lena's point. The serve, Chloe going short, and the error from Lena, and it's Chloe McGee with 11-9 lead at the interval. Good point of attack that for Lena. The cross court smash with slice proving fruitful on a number of occasions in this match and this week for the Dane. 14-11. The net kill from Chloe McGee. Good. Good return. Kjartsfeld. Just catching Chloe a little bit flat-footed. Oh.
13-15.
Again, good smash back at the point from where the shuttle came.
16-13.
Carswell has started to move forward. And the winner set up again by the excellent net play of Lina. Good smash from Chloe.
17-15.
In tight to the body of Lina. On the backhand side, very difficult to defend against. So 16-17. Crucial juncture in this match. Oh, just out.
17-0.
Yeah, it was out, I feel. Really hard to see from that angle, but I think the line judge got it just right. Now the Dane levels it up. Flick serve from Lina. Chloe taking on Lina at the net, coming out on top. The umpire very quick to overrule on that occasion. There's no way Chloe was going to stand for that. No real objection from Lina Kjartsfeld. I think Lina knew it was out. From Kjartsfeld. I think she feels McGee is influencing the line judges. Game point for Chloe McGee. Again, the net play from Kjartsfeld. Sublime. Oh, superb backhand. Pulling it cross court. Fantastic play from Lina under pressure.
18-20.
Second game to McGee. Salutes the crowd, her whole family behind her, of course. 21-18 victory for Chloe McGee in the second. One set all. Anybody's match. Final game. Really difficult to call. Of course, the weight of home expectation on the shoulders of Chloe McGee. Very unlike Lena to make a service error like that. Of course, if you examine Lena's service action, she has this folding, rolling action on the racket. And if the timing's not right, you can make an error. Carsfeld. Good smash from McGee. Yeah, definitely landing on the line. Good block defense from Carsfeld. Cross-court stick smash from Lena, just landing outside. Good drive on the return of serve.
Six, three.
few errors from Lena on that backhand.
4-6. Sevisova, 7-4.
Shuttle back across the net. Shuttle the backhand side cross court with great control. Not the best serve in the world from Chloe McGee. Way too much height over the net. Was on the back foot in that rally after the poor serve. Ms. Kjaersfeld with the interval lead, 11-7. So it's Kjaersfeld with the advantage in this deciding set. good smash around the head from the Dane.
12-7. Service over.
Oh, a little bit of luck.
8-12.
Crowd getting behind their girl.
Service fault called.
Oh, service fault called against Chloe service McGee.
13-8. Chloe, please.
Looked okay to me. His head is starting to drop a little bit. He needs to regain focus and composure. 4 points behind. In our home international final. The honourable thing to do, cheer a bad shot from your opponent, but
set is over. 49.
Chloe's still reeling, I think, from that service call. Really has to compose herself now and refocus. This game will certainly get out of reach very quickly. Forced to lift from the net shot again.
Service over. 10-14.
Come on. Two smashes from Carlsfeld.
11-14.
Two rallies just out. Oh, a little bit of luck again for the Dane.
Set is over.
Shit. Catching the top of the net.
15-11.
Falling over. Chance for Chloe. Made every effort. Final. That's better from McGee. Good angle around the head from Lena.
17-12.
Good power.
30-17.
Wasn't a bad flick from Lena. Quick feet, getting behind the shuttle. Deep angle.
Yeah! 14-17.
Here, landing just in from the
game.
Chloe's battling qualities keeping her going here. Just trailing by two now. Kjaersvold now within two of the championship title. It's do or die time now for Chloe. Needs to get a run of points on her serve. Put the pressure on Lena. Not like that, I'm afraid.
Over,
poor execution of this match, nowhere near. That's match point for the Dane. Four match points. Ah, well played, Chloe. Battling and fighting hard.
17-20.
One saved. Second save. Good smash into the body.
18-20.
Yeah, that's it. Change of tactic on the reserve for Lena. And I think well-deserved title for Lena Kjaersvold. Good win in the semi-final, as I said, over Olga Konen. Disappointment for Chloe. She's talking to the service judge. But a championship win for Lena Kjaersvold. Back shortly with an interview with the winner, followed by the men's singles final. Scott Evans against Lucas Corvée.